Hey guys, welcome on back to the shop here. This is John. This is just a brief follow-up in conjunction with the video that I put out a couple of days ago concerning the import ER collets. First and foremost, let me thank everybody that has made a comment or offered a suggestion. I think I've replied back individually to everybody, but if I skip someone, please know how much I appreciate your suggestions and taking a few moments to leave comments. And some of those suggestions were very detailed, and I know that takes some time and no small effort to put those thoughts down and put those in the comments section. And I'm very grateful for that. That's what I love about the YouTube community, that the information flows freely. So let's go back to what I found out. The video that was put out 3 or 4 days ago was actually recorded about a month ago. One thing about YouTube that they have right now is you can actually load videos and schedule them, and you can schedule them to be released at a later date. So what I normally do is about once a week, just schedule to release one, and it just makes it easier for me to do that in case I get behind here in the shop. So here's where I stand. The video that I had showed ER32 and ER25 collets. Well, the issue with the ER32 collets that I had over the milling machine, those were clearly, without doubt, metric collets that were labeled imperial. The reason I know that is I took no small amount of time to go in and literally measure each one of those. And I had some metric stuff here, and the ability to clamp down on the metric versus the imperial led me to believe that absolutely those were just relabeled metric and trying to be used and substituted for imperial. The other thing I found out when I went into, I bought those off Amazon, which Amazon refunded the money on those. I went in to check the description after I bought them, and when I was doing the return process, I noticed that someone else had bought those, and before I left my comment, and even after I determined they must be metric, sure enough, the comment of the review was that these were metric collets that had been misidentified in Amazon's catalog, and they were actually, description was totally wrong and the labeling was wrong on those. So Amazon gave the money back on those. I don't have any of those. The other set I bought off eBay, and the mandrel, the chuck came from Banggood, but the ER25 collets came off eBay. It was a set, I think, from 16ths, from 1/8 all the way up to 5/8. Those were clearly just inferior product. I have tried everything. I've tried deburring some of those. I still have those. It was too late to get any money back on those. I'm just going to chalk those up. Out of that set of 10 or 12 collets, there's only about 2 or 3 that are very useful at all. And of course, they're the odd size that I would not use. The normal fractional sizes that I use a lot of, you know, 8 by 16ths. I don't use a lot of 32nds here in the shop, but those that are 16th are pretty much unusable. So anyway, that's where it is. I'm going to show you what I had to do and take you to the lathe here and show what the final result after working pretty diligently for over a week or two trying to make these collets work. But at the end of the day, they're not any good. And some people have said, and correctly so, that sometimes that Asian is a crapshoot, that sometimes, and usually it's a correlation between the more money you pay, the better quality. And I'll admit, I tried to cheap out on this, but I just cheaped out a little bit too much on these. Anyway, enough rambling. Join me here at the lathe and the bench, and I'll show you what I did to make these happen. Well, here's what I did to clean it up to this point right here, which is still far from being pleased, but at least I've got 3 or 4 collets I suppose I could use. I used the Optivisor here with a loop on it to really get up close. And these things were full of swarf. I mean, it was terrible. It was just unbelievable. At a casual glance, you didn't notice it. But when I was using the Optivisor here, you could literally see shreds, and that's no exaggeration. There were shreds of metal that, I don't know whether, I think they probably used a slitting saw to cut this, it looks like. And the slitting saw left behind, it was just unbelievable. I would have to take this shim stock, and I went down through each one of these things, you know, on each side, and just literally having to pull that stuff out. In fact, there's a little piece that's still coming out of it. But each time I would do this, I would literally get a pile of swarf that was there. Then on those little shreds and stuff, I had to go in and actually pull that out. But anyway, that took hours to go down through there because I was just being as careful as I could. Then after I got through with that, I took sandpaper, which I don't think I have laying here right now. But then I took sandpaper and put each one of these in a vise. And then I came through and kind of undercut right there to kind of make sure those edges. And to no avail. So I think what this is just a bad set of cheap collets. And so anyway, that's where I am. Okay, I'm at the lathe and I'm just going to do a few tests right here to show that everything seems to be pretty true. I know there were a lot of questions about the spindle accuracy. The spindle in the lathe is virtually no run out, any measurable run out with my half thousandths indicator that's there. Now, I'm going to put this on the back and I'm just going to turn it. I've got the point of the indicator just stuck right in there about an eighth of an inch. And I'm probably picking up maybe about a half a thousandth. As I move it in, I'm actually about halfway in where everything is sitting down and there's no movement there. I'm going to come all the way on in a little bit. And again, there's no movement at all when I get to that. Out on the very edge of it there a little bit, I've got about 1/1000th of a movement, which I wish was a little bit less, but again, I'm not dealing with very expensive material to start with. I'm going to put in, I don't have any or very many dowel pins or anything of accurate size. I've got some drill rod and so forth that I do, but what I can do here is I've got some fairly new drills that haven't been beat up on the end, so I'm going to actually just chuck those up and just show you a few things as far as that you might see how accurate that it has become since I've done that work. I'm just going to use a few of them here at random as I'm pulling out. Again, this is a fairly good drill that I've got at 7/32 of an inch, and I'm just going to put that in. Now, I've got my chuck held in with a drawbar, and I'm going to tighten this up, and I'm just going to give it a good bump, make sure everything is in there, roll back my indicator, and leave it right there, and then I'm just going to turn this over. So with the 7/32, I may be just a little bit over 1/1000th. Again, these things, where they are advertised at, 2 10,000ths, I'm not sure about that because this one right here is showing at 1/1000th. Again, I'm not banking on the accuracy of that drill, but it should be pretty good. I wish I had dowel pins or gauge pins, but I just don't have that to do. Let's try another one. I'm going to use a 1/8 drill bit. This is a brand new drill bit. I buy those in packages. And this one has never been in a chuck or anything. I just pulled it out of the storage that's over there, out of my drawer where I've got extra drill bits. Bring it down slightly. I sure wish I had one of those fine-tune indicator holders, but I don't have that. See, that's with an eighth of an inch, and that's just unacceptable. Let me bring it out a little bit. I may be on some writing where that thing is held. All right, bring it up just a little bit closer. And see, now that I'm up and got some good meat on that drill, I'm at about 1/1000th. Now, as you bring it out, that's a bunch. But again, I don't know. I'm just using drills here. But if it's up there close like that, I guess at least you'll have to say where it's sticking out of the collet, that it's within 1/1000th of an inch. Try a couple of more here. This is 1/4 inch. So on 1/4 inch, I'm rocking about 1/1000th of an inch on it. I want to get out to the end. It's coming on up quite a bit off when you get out to the end. I don't like that. I'm gonna try 3/8, and what I have here for the 3/8 is I've got a new end mill. All right, so I'm gonna roll the 3/8 around and see what it's like. And see, that's just all over the board. And that's an end meal. And that's just swinging entirely too much right there. Well, that's the saga of the Collets. I'm going to just kind of let this sleeping dog lie. And again, thank you so much for your suggestions. Thank you so much for the many people offering to help. And they were very thoughtful suggestions. And I tried a whole bunch of those suggestions. And because of that, I was able to get a few of them to actually work correctly. But all of them, they were not. Once again, thank you for all of your help. And be sure to join me back here in the shop as we continue doing some other little projects. Until next time. From one side of a two-car garage here in the great state of Texas, this is John. We'll meet right back here in the shop.